We want to evaluate the given expression if natural log x equals 2, natural log y equals 3, and natural log z equals 5. But we have to be careful about this because notice how we have a quotient of two logarithms, so we cannot write this as a difference of two logarithms using the quotient property of logs given here. This tells us the log of x divided by y equals log x minus log y. But we don't have the log of a quotient, we have the quotient of two logs. So we'll have to expand the numerator and denominator separately and then perform substitution from the given information. But before we start, let's take a look at the denominator. Notice how we have natural log x times z squared. So while we could take the exponent of 2 and move it to the front of the natural log using our power property of logarithms here, I think it'll be easier to keep track of if we use our exponent rules, where we have y to the first, z to the first squared, and in this form, multiply the exponents. So let's go ahead and write this as natural log x to the negative 1, y to the second, divided by natural log y to the second, z to the second. And now in this form, notice both the numerator and denominator contain natural log of a product. So using the product property of logarithms here, we can rewrite the numerator and denominator as a sum of two logarithms. So for the numerator, we'd have natural log x to the negative 1 plus natural log y to the second. Again, we have a sum here because we have natural log of x to the negative 1 times y squared. And then for the denominator, we would have natural log y squared plus natural log z squared. And now we are going to apply the power property of logarithms, which means we can take the exponent, in this case n, and write it as n times a logarithm. So we can move the exponent of negative 1 to the front, move the exponent of 2 to the front of the logarithm, and here as well. Which means now we have negative 1 natural log x. Of course, the 1 is optional. We could just write negative natural log x. And then it would be plus 2 natural log y divided by the quantity 2 natural log y and plus 2 natural log z. And now in this form, we can perform substitution for natural log x, natural log y, and natural log z. So we'll have negative 1 times natural log x, which is equal to 2, plus 2 times natural log y, which is equal to 3. And then for the denominator, we'll have 2 times natural log y, which again is 3, plus 2 times natural log z, which is 5. So we'll have negative 2 plus 6 all over 6 plus 10, which is equal to 4 sixteenths. Well, 4 sixteenths simplifies to 1 fourth, or if we want, 0.25. And that'll do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.